So today we'll see this here, just here. This we have done, why? And this try also we have done. And this also we have done, this one and this one. So today we'll see the other here, that is try or. This we'll see, and triangle we'll see. This left out, all that we'll see today. Let us go to that one. So if you see here, this one. Similarly, try and try or are the counterparts of when and what. So these are the counterparts here. The way this try is a counterpart for this while. So yesterday we have seen how this try is used. So you should not be forgetting the participants. So you should remember. Let me just recollect that one for anyone for the reference sake. This one we have seen, this one, how it is helping us, and this one we have seen, and the same piece of code, this try also we have seen in some other slide. The slide is anyone remembering that we use the try and with the pictorial representation, a piece of small piece of code, anyone remembering? Are you still there?
Yes.
Yeah. So the you people are remembering, right, where we have used the try? So can anyone? Can anyone tell where we are using that one?
Output net is driven by two nets.
Output is driven by?
Two nets, two different nets.
Two different nets.
Yes.
Okay, any other guy?
I think the more than two, the main output is driven by more than one output. Like
main output is driven by more than one output.
Yeah, I mean, output. Just like.
Okay. Any other person there, participant? Any so far two participants able to speak and their answer is correct. And any other able to speak there? Kindly speak. Let us make this one interactive rather stereotype from only one side. So that's the main intention of asking. Nothing else. There is no pass, there is no fail, there is no correct, there is no wrong. Just to have an interaction, live interaction. Can someone unmute and tell where is that? At least in which slide you people have seen the try portion, I was actually pointing out, saying that this is the try. So in which portion, which slide, just in. Just to make an interactive session, I'm asking. Can anyone unmute and tell? Nobody? Okay. somebody trying to.
I think slide number 11, Jatir.
Okay. Slide number 11.
I think so.
Okay, this is the slide number 11. Okay, not an issue where that one is. The point here is what I'm trying to make here is just this one, that this output here, this is let me take the pen, and this is the output that we are writing here, this output. Instead, apart from that, we do have another, this one, try. Where do we use that is the question I was just asking. So the answer has come when this is one gate and there is another gate, and these two gates outputs here are both are driving the only one output net, one output net. In such case, we use this try. That's the answer that has come. So the point here is, how about thinking this one? That slide, I don't recollect where it is. But what about this one here? If you see this one, this is actually a buffer. This is actually a buffer. But if there are two types of buffers now. There is another buffer, like if you keep the other one here. This is another buffer. Then what is the difference between these two means? When zero comes, this functions. When one comes, this functions. So this is output here. If you see this output here, O1, let us say in this case, it is a O2. This point, this case is where this contention issues are there. So there where either we resolve the contention issue using the strength levels, or we resolve the contention issue using the WAND and the WAR method. So in this case, here somewhere WAR, here. In this case, we use the WAR, and in this case, we resolve the contention issue using the WAR. Now the point is that this try, is a functional identical to this one. When net is driven by more than one tri-state gate, this is the key point. When net is driven by more than one tri-state gate, this should be the tri-state gate. This is the key point. Tri-state gate. It is declared as a try rather than while. This is the key takeaway. The key point is. Takeaway is this. Forever, we should not forget this one. When try will be used means forget about the slide and the figure, pictorial representation. When net is driven, net means anything that is connected here, just like that. For example, if you take this AND gate, and this is one net, this is the second net, and this is the third. In this, one and two nets are input nets. And the third net is output. So basically, wire which is connecting to the logic, that is the net. So when this net is driven means this Y is actually driven by 192. So when net is driven by more than one tri-state gate. That is the point. Simply, if you take this gate, for example, two AND gates, and they are driving the same net, that is one. Can we use try? Answer is no. It should have been a tri-state gate. Tri-state gates here we have, one is a buff. The keyword here is buff if one is a keyword, very lucky word. And the other buff is this one. That is when buff if zero. And we have this one, not gate. Even we can try state this one. This is not if one, not if 1, and we can tri-state another this one inverter like this. This is a not if 0. So these are the tri-state gates. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4. Basically, the 4 tri-state gates are there in our Verilog SDL language as the primitives. So them, whenever we are using, then if they are driving more than this is net is driven, if it is net output net is driven by more than one tri-state gate, then such a net is declared as a tri. That is the point that we should not forget. Let us clear this off too. Now coming to this one here, that why we are using, this is the point. The distinction is for better clarity. You can try without try also. Will it work or not? That you can simulate in the simulator. But according to this point, it should work. Why we are writing the try means it is for better clarity. The language people are telling us, those who developed the compiler, this Verilog HDL language, they are saying that it is for better clarity. Now, what is our job is to simulate without using the try. So let you people try and report. So now coming to the other one here, try and try off are the counterparts of WAND and WAR. Why we use WAND and WAR? It is very clear from yesterday's discussion that when contention issue comes to resolve the problem, then we are using this WAND and WAR. If contention issue comes, then in a tri-state here, this is the slide number. Actually, I was searching for this one actually earlier. So it is here at 22. So now if you see this buffif for one, this one, and this one buffif 0, both are tri-state gates, and their outputs actually are driven by this A and B. So in such case, this is represented with tri. So my question, point earlier was, you try it out only, it should give the output according to this point. The distinction is for better clarity. Simply the reason is for better clarity that we have. So why don't we try this piece of code line, this one, simulate and ensure that even with wire it is working. So anyway, the point here is this try and try or, they work like a WAND and WAR, and they help us to resolve the problem yesterday what we have seen, this contention issue. When contention problem coming here, so this WAR has helped us to resolve the problem based on the OR logic. Similarly, AND has helped us to resolve the problem. This WAND has helped us to resolve the contention issue problem that is coming here based on the AND logic. Similarly, in tri-state gates, this is not a tri-state gate. Buff is not a tri-state gate. So if we are using a tri-state gate and which is driving output is driven by more than one net, so in such case it is advised by the compiler people, use try and try off. It is anyway compulsory to use, unlike here better clarity. You use try or not, that may not be affecting. You try that in the simulator, this piece of code, but this one here, try and try off, is anyway required because This contention issue will come when more than one is driving the net. Contention issue will come. Either that contention needs to be resolved using the AND logic or OR logic. So that's why this try AND and try OR we have to anyway use. So that is the point here. So this point already we have covered. Now coming to the try 1 and try 0. This is try 0 and try AND provider respective default outputs and avoid any of the following circuit having a tri-stated input. This is, if you see the example here, if it is here, yes, it is here. You look at this one here, this particular tri-zero. This is the T-R-I, it's not the O, it is a zero, this one. This one is a zero. Similarly, this one is a one. And what is tri-zero here? This one, this gate is G0 gate is a O1 is a tri-0. Okay, let us draw that one. let us draw that buff if one. This is buff if one, and this is enable. This is enable. And what is that we have here? Input I, and what is that we have output? O. Now, when enable is removed, when enable, and how, when it will work actually? When enable is one, whatever this I value that is seen on the O one, right? When enable is removed, then what happens here is, this is like a open circuit. This is like a open circuit. Now this value is held at a high impedance state, that is Z or Z, high impedance state. And we don't want it to be high impedance state when this control is this control is removed. We don't want it to be at Z. Either we want it to be at zero or we want it to be at one. In such case, this particular O output needs to be tied to either try zero, what you want, or try one. Is that clear to everyone there? What is the use of this? Is that clear?
Yes, it is clear.
Okay, thank you. So if you have queries, you can ask. One more time, let me very quickly summarize this one. What is that here is, when there is a try state gate will have the control. This control and this control, there is a difference. There is a difference here, right? When this is one, then only this input is seen on the output side. When this is zero, then only this input is seen on the output. Now the point is, if this is removed here, one is removed, how this gate is going to behave? It is going to behave like a tri-state output, means output is held at a high impedance state, neither zero nor one, high impedance state. Now similarly, this one here, when zero is removed, this O2 is held at a high impedance state. But we don't want it to be held at this high impedance state Z. Either we want it to be at zero or one. If you want it to be at zero, then you declare such a output. In this case, it is a O1. Such an output, you declare it as with a try zero space that output variable. And if you want it to be at one, when you remove the control, then you try, you declare it as a try one. Hope this is clear to everyone. Kindly ask if you have any queries. Let us move to the next one. So where they are helpful and all, every theory is there here. You can go through the theory. Already this PPT I have shared. Okay. Now coming to the final net data type, supply 0 and supply 1. So this you will appreciate if you show one example. Let me show the example so that you can appreciate that. In this switch level, this is called switch level primitive. In this switch level primitive, we have something called like this. This is your NMOS, this is your PMOS. In a CMOS, we have a pull up device and there is a pull down device. Pull up is a P type, and we connect these gates, and here we have to have VDD. And we have to have here a VSS or ground. So this VDD value in the verilog HDL. So how do we represent? So there where this slide is talking about, that is this one. you see everyone here, just a moment. You see this 4 and 5? You see this 4 and 5? Here, this is a CMOS inverter. What we have inverter, inverter output, inverter in, meaning like this. This is the PMOS and this is MOS. We tied them. And here we have VDD. And here we have G and D ground. And instead VDD in this example, we have PWR. And this is your, this one, inverter in, and this one is the inverter out, this one. Now this is with the keyword output, with the keyword input, we have this inverter underscore out, inverter underscore in. But how do you declare this PWR? How do you declare this G and D ground? For that purpose, we have the supply 0 keyword and a supply 1 keyword. Is that clear? Is that clear, this point?
Yeah.
Okay. So that is what here, this one, where was it? This supply 1 and supply 0, supply 0 and supply 1 are the keywords signifying high and low side supplies. So that's all this about this what we call net data type. Now we have to move towards understanding the other portion of this slide 1. We actually move to this discussion from here. From this portion. From this point to that side we move. From this point. So we have completed our entire discussion here, 1 to 9. If you have any queries, you can ask here, or else you can think also. So let us move to this from here. What about this point number 10? So point number 10 says, this one if you focus here, and this one if you focus, that is reset, is a scalar type, and D bus is a vector type. So if vector type are there, how do we declare? We declare them like that. This is the type here, net data type here. This is the VOR in this example, WOR. And thereafter, if you leave like that, then it is called scalar declaration. And if it is a vector, then what is the size of that vector? In this taken example, say 1 colon 0, that is D bus. So vector type. There are various ways in the textbooks. If you see 0 to 7 and then minus 2 colon 0 minus 1, all that is permissible here in this vector size declaration. So the point here is we have, let me clear this one, something called big end endian. And something big Indian and little Indian. Indian. END. NDIAN. Little Indian. Big Indian. So if you have this one, this is one way of having, let us say, vector size. The other way of having the vector size is, let us say, it is 0 colon 7. Okay. It is colon here. Here is a colon. And here is a colon. So in this, if you see the first case, in the MSB side we have 7. LSB side we have 0. This is your LSB side. You have 0. But in this, the second example, the MSB side you have 0, the LSB side you have 7. this is called Little Indian. This one is a Little Indian notation, and the other one is a Big Indian notation. So Big Indian notation is this one, where LSB set is a higher value. Say where LSB set higher value is there, that is a Big Indian. Where LSB set is a lower value is there, that is a Little Indian method. So that is permissible in the very large HDL. Why it is there, I don't know, but that is permissible. The point is, it is advised to use only one type of notation, and that is this one, that is Little Indian notation. Why? Because generally our human mind will work like the moment when we say A of 7, we generally think that it is some sort of MSB. When we say A of 0, it is some sort of LSB. That's how our mind works. So what is advised by the people? Use in your vector declarations Little Indian method. This is Little Indian method, where LSB set is a lower value. It's a Little Indian method. So that we have to use. Why? Because our mind works like that. A of 7 means generally anyone will think maybe he's talking about or she is talking about MSB bit. A of 0 means he is talking about or she is talking about LSB. So meaning what? This is how we have to represent instead of Big Indian notation like this. Then in that case, what is MSB means? A of 0 is actually MSB in this case. In this case, we are actually referring A of 0, MSB, and A of 7 is LSB. So that's why this is not suggested, advised by the people who are working in industry. They say that you use this sort of. That's it about vector. So let us move to the next. Here, register type, we have, mostly we use some like loops for some loop. So in this loop, what is required is loop index variable is required. So in such cases, mostly we prefer to use integer, this integer. And to print the simulation time, we use this dollar time. Is there yesterday some other session we have seen? Anything that starts with a dollar is there? Is there anyone? Anything that starts with a dollar is what?
Say system task.
System
task or function.
Yes. What is the difference between system task and system function?
One returns value and one does not.
Yeah, what is that? What is that thing that returns?
Function returns and task does not.
So this one is what?
This was the function.
This is a system function.
Yeah.
So this time is that one. So if you want to have time variable, like time, say. This is T1 comma T2 like that. So these variables will hold simulation time. For simulation time, this time is used. Other than that, there is no use of this variable. This time variable. The way integer variable mostly used in a loop indexes for the purpose of loop index, time is for holding like the time, space, this variable. So anything that you declare, like wire we are using, how we are using wire A comma B. Now what is the use of this A comma B means they are type net data type. And what they do means anywhere for the connectivity they may be used. Like for example, here I'm using A, B. So in such case, I may be using this wire. So likewise, what is this time is a container. What it container holds, so it holds the simulation time. Now this simulation time could be a integer value or a real value. In real value, it's a real time. In a normal integer, that is like 5 nanoseconds, whatever that integer portion, not that fraction like 5.34, something like that. If this also you want to see in the simulator, then you have to use real time. This time is only for 5, 7, 9, like that. And coming to the real, anything that we want to send somewhere, I think I have you. Oh, this one. Such 3.14. Here also on there. Something, some assignments you want to give, some value you want to define, like a 3.72, like that. And that should be a real. This is actually real. So real B equal to, like, so, but the point here, what you have to understand is, two points you have to keep in mind. One is simulation. The other is synthesis. So, okay, Verilog is allowing something to declare or define like this. Real B equal to 3.72, something like that. So is it supported by the synthesizer tool, real data type? Or is it only in the simulation? That needs to be, that we have to question ourselves. Every construct in the language, every keyword that we are learning here, is it supported by the Verilog HDL synthesizer tool? That is the question that we have to question. So that we'll address later on. But the point here is this real usage is that. So let me clear everything here. Okay, very quickly, reg is most frequently used in synthesis code means it's the RTL code. When we say it's RTL, it's a register transfer level. Register transfer level means any Verilog HDL code which is acceptable to the synthesizer. That is called RTL. RTL means any code that is written and acceptable to the synthesizer. Meaning, the moment it is acceptable to the synthesizer, what it does, it gives us a netlist hardware. So this reg is okay, no problem using, and integer also no problem. This time, all are mostly used in simulation, not in RTL. They are used in synthesizers. Synthesizer means it's a software. Who will develop EDA? Fellows will develop. What is EDA? Electronic Design Automation. Who is developing this? Some EDA tool. For example, you have Cadence RTL compiler. Earlier it was the RTL compiler, but nowadays the name they changed and they are calling it as a genus. Genus. They are calling it as a genus. And we have some design compiler, DC, maybe from Synopsys. So this real may be supported in the DC design compiler, and it may not be supported by the genus. So that we have to ensure before using this real or anything that that you use. So the most frequently this time, real time anyway for sure, is used in the simulation. But coming to the real, we have to consult the EDA manual, whether in my code, in my RTL code, where I am writing my RTL code, if need arises to declare something like 3.74 with a container. Container means, the moment when I say container, it's a data type. That data type is forced to use real, because the value that you are so using is something 7.97, something like that. The point is that RTL code, whether which tool you are using, which EDA tool you are using, that EDA tool whether supports real, that you have to get it the clarification. If that is clear, then you can use that real. Okay, some tools support and some are not supporting. That I can say. But coming to the time and real time, they are for sure they are used in the simulation. So these are the examples here. You see the reg CNT and the reg. This you have to remember how vector is declared with a square brackets. With a square bracket here. This is the in between a colon. This colon will come. And the value may be 2, 0. Meaning what? 0, 1, 2. three values are permitted here. The vector size, SAT vector size here is a 3. In this taken example, the vector size is a 32. So now integer A, B, C here. So these are 32 bit signed there. So like that we have here examples how we declare them. So let us go to this constant here. Now coming to this, we have for example parameter. If you see the parameter, it's a keyword. Parameter is a keyword. It is the way we have earlier seen reg is a keyword, integer is a keyword, time is a keyword, real is a keyword, real time is a keyword. Similarly, all this total 1 to 9 here, while, try, war, trior, van, trend, all these are what? They are keywords. Likewise, here we have this parameter is a keyword. So, what is the syntax? Syntax is this parameter space, whatever that variable that you want to have, you have it equal to, and what is the constant value that you want to assign? You assign. If multiple variables are there, then you separate with a comma. You don't need to have one more time parameter keyword. Just you have to separate with a comma and the other variable, and what is the constant value that you want. The moment you think that it is done, you are done, then you have to have this semicolon. If there is only one, for example, here in this case, let us say this is not there yet. This portion is not there, suppose, this portion. Then here only you have to have semicolon. Here only you have to have semicolon. That's it. That's how constants are defined. Now, parameter apart from constants, lot more uses are there. In subsequent classes, we'll see. For example, parameterized modules we write. So, what is meant by parameterizing module? What is meant by generic module? And all in subsequent classes we will see. So now moving further, we have arrays here. So this, you see this, for example, this one. The point here is my underscore mem is a array. And the size of that array is 0 to 63, meaning 64, starting from 0 through 63. That is total 64. Size of the array is 64. And each array is capable of holding here 4 bits. 4 bits. Likewise, every location, array location, how many array locations are there? Total 64 locations are there. Every location is capable of holding how many bits means? That depends upon this one. If this would have been, say, 1:0, then every array location will hold 8 bits. If this would have been 0 to 31, then array locations are only 32. So, for memory modeling, this sort of dimension or this sort of array is useful for memory. Now coming to what else here? Here this point here. You see this one braces or floor brackets. These are the concatenation operator. More we'll see in the operator, very large GL operator in a data flow level modeling. But the here, since we have taken the example, suppose say I have A as a 1 and B as a 0. B as a 0. Now I want to assign, suppose say there is a wire and the wire is a vector type 1:0. 1:0. This is a wire. What is the size of this wire? 2 bits. So now Y is getting assignment from this A comma B. So I am concatenating this A value and B value with the help of this flower brackets or braces. So this is a concatenation operator. Since A is scalar, since B is a scalar, so Cisco value is now becoming 2-bit, and the size of this Y is also 2-bit, like that. The point is to focus, my focus is on concatenation operator, to tell you that this is a concatenation operator. Now, coming to this portion I am leaving, subsequent classes we will see. So now, we are entering into the slowly modeling. At this point, what we have to understand is, most frequently people will use how you are modeling, how you are modeling that problem. If you have some formula, how you model that one. How you model means people simply buzzwords. I feel like they are simply confusing the others. Modeling nothing but simply describing how you are describing. How you are describing. How you describe, that is what the modeling. Instead of saying that your fellows, how you are modeling, they're confused. Baba, modeling is how you are describing. Describing what? What you describe? Your behavior of the hardware. What is your behavior of the hardware? So for example, everyone studied in STLD, switching theory and logic design. The behavior of the AND gate, everyone familiar. The famous is this. When 00 comes, when 01 comes, when 10 comes, when 11 comes, here it is 1 and the rest of the places it is 0. That's the behavior. Now this behavior we have to describe, and the people, they call it as, instead of describing, modeling. And that modeling is possible in either of these ways. One is switch level modeling, one is a gate level modeling, the other is a data flow level modeling, behavioral level modeling, structural level modeling, and a mixed level modeling. Basically, we have only this 1, 2, 3, 4. This structural mixed means, from mixed you understood straight away. You don't need to tell. Mixed means either of this you might have mixed. In describing modeling, or all of them, you might have mixed all of them also, no problem. So that is called mixed level modeling. So let me clear this. Coming to the structural modeling, you might have described in either of this, okay? You might have described here some functional block. Let us say that block is a F1, and here you might have described some functional block F2. Only if you interconnect F1 and F2, and if interconnect them in a way that is required to be, and you give some inputs to them, and you obtain some output. Here you are not describing anything functionality. Are you describing here inside? Are you describing any functionality here? Nothing. No? Simply you described model already is there, and that is your top module F1. You are simply getting it here, and something is described already in some modeling level here, and here that you are getting, and you are appropriately making connections here, and appropriately you are giving some inputs, and appropriately you are obtaining some outputs. That's it. You are not describing any logic. Basically, you are simply making interconnections. So this sort of description is a structural level modeling. Structural level modeling means inside you don't write any logic. You simply bring already described one and you appropriately interconnect, and you get the you give the input and you get the output. That's it. So now the point here is, when we are studying all this, we have to understand one thing. What is that industry people are today doing? So today some complex designs are there, very, very complex. Very means very. Intel 12, Intel, I don't know, Intel 9, something they are talking. So how complex those designs are. So can we sit at the switch level to describe that functionality? What is switch level function? Switch level means, we have something like a earlier I shown in some slide, that is, we have NMOS primitive, NMOS keyword is there with us. Verilog, with us means in the Verilog language. PMOS keyword is there, and also CMOS keyword is there. And we have to describe our hardware functionality using this. When I can describe, only when if I have circuit diagram, then only I can describe. For such complex, so Intel 9 processor or Intel 12 processor, is it possible to know the inside circuit diagram? No way, it's not possible. Then what is possible? Behavior is possible. What is the behavior that you know inside? How in this Intel different modules will behave? So that behavior is possible. If that behavior here, if you are coding, this is higher abstraction level. Lower abstraction level is this one. Switch level modeling is a lower abstraction level. Bit higher abstraction level is gate level. Now the gate level also same problem. How can I imagine the gates required inside the Intel 9 or Intel 12? Is it possible? Practically impossible. Years it may take to count the gates inside, billion, trillion gates. So such gates knowledge, if it is there with me or with anyone, why they go to the tool called synthesizer? Why they go to the tool called synthesizer? The job of the synthesizer is to take a high level modeling, behavioral level modeling, and to give here gate level netlist. So for that point of view, these two, somebody kindly mute, somebody kindly mute. Somebody please check their mic and kindly mute. So you hope you people are understanding what I am trying to convey here, switch level and gate level. In a gate level, we have the keywords such as basic primitives, we call them, and such as OR, NOR, OR, NAND, all these primitive gates are, we'll see, I will show that slide. I'm not skipping that part. I will show that. Just before going that, I'm just letting you know that what is there in gate level. In gate level, what is there means this is what is there. The primitives are there inside. So if I want to describe my half adder, I know that my half adder having one XOR gate. I know that my half adder also having one AND gate. I give here some input to this, and I give some input to these two gates, and I obtain here some, and I obtain here carry out. I know this. Since I know, I can code using gate level modeling, because in gate level modeling, these gates, straight away XOR gate keyword is available, and the syntax is first output variable and then followed by that input variable. That is the syntax, simple syntax. This is, since how I can able to use this primitive, if I know the gate level circuit. Switch level circuit means what? Transistor circuit, transistor level circuit. If I know, then I can use NMOS, PMOS like that. So, but can you imagine a person or anyone knowing a complex circuit inside of what are, how many gates are there, in which way they are connected, how many transistors are there, in which way they are connected? It is practically not possible nowadays. So that's why this switch level and gate level modeling, for our understanding purpose, that language having that capability, that's it. But practically speaking, no one will be using them in industry, to my knowledge. So then what they use is, they use this behavioral level modeling. In the behavioral level modeling, data flow level modeling constructs are, there's some operator, what we call operator, that we'll see shortly, don't go panic at this. Operators are there. So these operators are most frequently used inside the behavioral level modeling. Inside the behavioral level modeling, I don't need to really know this circuit operator, how gates are required, in which fashion they are connected, I don't require to know. I simply know that when 0, 0 comes, my sum is 0, my carry is 0. When 0, 1 comes, my sum is 1, my carry is 0. When 1, 0 comes, sum is 1, carry. This behavior if I write using behavioral level modeling, then it is a job of the synthesizer to give me this gate level netlist. This is the synthesizer job. And who will take me till transistor backend tools? Backend tools will take me to the transistor. Back, I said in my first commencement day, there are tools, front end, there are back end tools. They take till that transistor, that is finally GDS2, that is GDS2 file, which we send to the foundry people. So guys, with this, what I'm trying to convey is, we will learn this. We have to learn as a student of Virla SDL, which level capability is there, gate level. But understand that this is most powerful. And one more point, you must be familiar that even this is nowadays, some companies are not even using this behavioral level modeling. What they are using HLS. High-level synthesis, HLS, high-level synthesis. They are writing functions in C or C++. What functions they are writing? Whatever the behavior that you have in mind your arithmetic logic unit. Arithmetic logic unit is divided into arithmetic unit and logical unit. Again, arithmetic unit is divided into several. Adder, division, subtractor, what not, several. So, for example, this behavior. This behavior they are writing in what? Maybe C or maybe C++. Now, this HLS software, that is high level synthesis tool, to this tool they are giving this written function. Written function they are giving it to high level synthesis tool. This tool, what it is giving output is, it is giving a output called RTL, which we use to write. This everything is a RTL, which is synthesizable, is a RTL, mostly this portion is a RTL. Now, human intervention, actually in a company, who will write a behavioral level model? A person will write. This person is eliminated. Now, with the help of HLS, high level synthesis tool, and this person is required to upgrade here with the C++ function. This person, if don't want to lose the job, he or she needs to upgrade their skills C++ and the usage of this tool. Don't go panic, guys. Then what is the point of now learning the Verilog HDL? That may be the question to many. You don't need to go panic. Why? Because I will tell. Now, few companies like your Xilinx, some say Xilinx, some say Xilinx, and there is a Altera. They are the major fighter of competitors, vendors in a FPGA world. Field programmable gate array duniya, in this world, they are the players, competitors. They are actually doing this HLS, high level synthesis, and there is another also that is Aldec, I guess. So Aldec. So these are doing this HLS. Coming to your ASIC design competitors, your Cadence and your Synopsys. And your Mentor Graphics. These vendors are not into that now. They are not into HLS now. They are still with the RTL. Why? Because here there are some problems here. Some problems. Because HLS means it's a hectic job. Like it has to take a C and it has to take a library information. This library is a complex writing error. Because this should give a meaningful RTL output. Meaningful RTL. This meaningful RTL still they are not getting. That is what the news, current news, latest news. Just last few days ago I attended one. There it is being said by the company fellow that this is inefficient than what human develop. That's why this ASIC vendors are still with the RTL only. Means human is here. Still playing a role. So guys, that's why you don't need to go panic. For further coming 10 years, no doubt RTL is still going to exist. Okay, so meaning human intervention is still needed. This HLS is currently few players are doing, and that is inefficient. They themselves are telling that is also there. So but, that's why you master your RTL skills, very like HDL skills. So with that said, today we wrap our session.